This is a bike. This is an angle. This angle is getting slacker. The number's getting smaller. Now it's getting steeper. The number's getting bigger. This is the head tube angle. The slacker or lower it is, the more downhill focused the bike probably is. This is the seat tube angle. The steeper or higher it is, the better the bike will probably be at climbing. If you see two seat tube angle numbers, look at the one that says effective. These two numbers alone can tell you a lot about how a bike handles. Are they both relatively slack? It's probably a downhill bomber, but it may not be quick on the flats or great to climb with. Are they both relatively steep? Probably a speed demon on climbs, but not so stable through chunky downhill sections. A modern downhill bike might have a slack head tube angle of 64 degrees and a fairly slack seat tube angle of 74 degrees. A modern trail bike might have a slightly steeper head tube angle of 67 degrees and a steeper seat tube angle of 77 degrees. In general, most mountain bikes have been moving towards slacker head tube angles and steeper seat tube angles over time to improve downhill stability and performance while making climbing easier. Reach is a straight line measurement from the center of the head tube to an imaginary vertical line extending up from the bottom bracket. This number affects how the bike feels, so try out some bikes with different reach measurements to see what feels natural to you. Wheelbase is the distance between the centers of the two wheels, and the chainstay is the part between the rear wheel center and the bottom bracket. The longer both of these numbers get, the more stable the bike becomes, but the less poppy and responsive it's likely to be. So a modern downhill bike would likely have a longer wheelbase for stability, enabling it to plow through gnarly downhill terrain. A modern trail bike would have a comparatively shorter wheelbase, making it poppier and zippier over flatter terrain. That's basically it, but a few quickies. This is the bottom bracket height. The lower it is, the more you'll hit your pedals on rocks. This is the standover height. The lower it is, the easier it'll be to get on and off the bike. There are lots of other numbers, but you can pretty safely ignore them. Also, don't trust numbers. Try bikes out and see how they feel. I realize that's impossible with a global pandemic, but you know, Sunday. Okay, if you found this helpful, please hit like and subscribe. And if you know a beginner who could use this info, please send them the video link. Thanks for putting up with something a little different this week. The weather is currently too warm for fat biking, but still too icy and wet for regular riding, so I'm kind of stuck. And to be honest, I may take a week or two off from posting videos if I'm not able to get out and do any kind of real riding. Either way, I hope you can get outside and ride, and I'll see you next week. Or possibly a little bit later if the weather won't cooperate. Fingers crossed.